Hey everyone, welcome back to another GPU overview video. In this video, we are going to go over the GTX 1660 Ti. We're going to cover it in details regarding to where you can buy them from, how much do they cost, and as well as the expected profitability from this GPU. We're also going to give you overclocks for mining the most profitable coin on this GPU. And then after that, I will give you my conclusion whether you should buy this card or not. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Before I jump into the video, I asked you guys in the last GPU overview video, which was the 3060 Ti, whether you guys rather two articles on miningchamber.com or one article that will contain all the information, and everyone voted for the new system, so I went ahead and changed all the articles on miningchamber.com regarding to the GPUs to have only a single article where you can visit it and find additional information and up-to-date profitability as well as the overclock settings over there. So if you're watching this video 1 year from now, please feel free to visit this article. You'll find more information there and it's probably going to be more up-to-date than this video. Now let's go ahead and jump into the overview. So as you guys can see, we have the 1660 Ti EVGA single fan model. This GPU takes 3 slots if you're plugging it into a regular PC because of how thick it is. And it also takes a single 8-pin, which makes it easier for us to later on put more of them in one rig. And as of the coin that we will be mining on this GPU, it will be Ethereum, since as of the date of this video, it is the most profitable coin to mine on all of the GPUs. And now before we get too deep into that part, let's first talk about where you can buy this GPU and how much does it cost. When the 1660 Ti first came out, it came out at a price of around $300 MSRP, which gave it a really good edge comparing to the other GPUs at the performance that it can give. But now as the date of this video being published, the prices are different, and as you guys can see here, it says that you can find it on Amazon for around $600, which is a really crazy price for this card. So let's go ahead and visit Amazon and see what we find there. As you guys can see, you can hardly find any of the 1660 Ti's here. The only option we find is the MSI Gaming one for $550. So I do not recommend buying it from Amazon if you can't find it for a decent price. And then also as well in Newegg, it's all really high in prices and I wouldn't recommend buying them off of here. But if we go ahead and go to eBay, we can see here that there are multiple that have sold for a fairly decent price. So you can see that this one sold for $330 recently on January 22nd, and then there's another one $365 and $300. So there are one that are still selling for a good price, and what I would recommend doing is I would recommend checking eBay if you're looking to buy this GPU after watching this video. Now when it comes to the different models like EVGA and all the other ones, honestly they're all pretty good options, so you don't need to be really picky on this. But if you do find the MSI Gigabyte or EVGA over the other ones for the same price, then I would go with them instead. Now other than that, there are also the 1660 Supers and the 1660 Regulars. They are all pretty close in performance, but I will eventually make a video comparing them all together. So now let's go ahead and move on to the profitability of the 1660 Ti. So now to check the profitability, we are going to go to whattomine.com, and then now we're going to select 1660 Ti, and as for the overclocks, we know that we can push it more than 28 mega hash, so it would be around 31 mega hash. And then for the wattage, we can leave it at 80, so it's somewhere around there as well. And as of the electricity price, we're going to leave that at 10 cents per kilowatt hour. And now we can go ahead and hit calculate, and then they will give us the profitability of this GPU. So now as we can see here in the profitability, the most profitable coin to mine with the 1660 Ti is Ethereum, and it will make you around $2.78 a day. And then after electricity, it will make you around $2.60. So you guys can change the electricity cost based on your region and how much it costs you. But so far, it looks pretty good. So for this GPU to break even, you're making around almost $3 a day. So if we go ahead and open up a calculator and we can multiply $2.78 by 30. So a month, you'll be making $83 with this GPU. That is without electricity costs. And then let's say this GPU would cost you $400 max if you're looking to buy it at the state of this market right now. Although I wouldn't recommend buying it over $350, I feel like that's already too much for it. So now we can go ahead and divide 400 by $83, and then from there we can see how much it will break even. So with the profitability of the market that we're in right now, this GPU will break even in around 5 months, which is really good. So if you buy a rig full of them, then you can expect breaking even in around 5 to 6 months, and that is without electricity costs, like I mentioned. So if you want to check it with electricity cost, then I would come here and then put on your electricity cost and then use the second number instead of the first number, and that will give you a good estimate on how much you'll be making your money back. But guys, remember, all these profits don't stay the same. So maybe 1 month from this video being posted, the profits could have dropped around 20%, or they could have increased. So please come double check here, or you can visit our website miningchamber.com, and it will give you a real-time update on how much money this GPU will make you. And this part of the video is being recorded on January 22nd, and it won't be posted until later on, so please double check and you'll get a more accurate information. So now that we covered the profitability, we can go ahead and set it up into the test bench, and then we can run the miner and test the overclocks, as well as see how much power this GPU takes off the wall. So I've placed the GPU on our test bench, but as you guys can see, the Vega frame was built for a full length GPU rather than a mini GPU, so it didn't really support it that well, but it's okay as long as these screws hold up. And then after that, we're going to run the initial tests in Windows 10. So we will be using the GTX 1660 Ti on Ethereum, because Ethereum is the most profitable coin to mine on this GPU as of this date. And then also, this system pulls around 30 watts off of the wall without any GPU. So with the GPU, it pulls around 35 to 40 watts, which means that anything above 30 will be just the GPU itself. And now let's go ahead and run Phoenix Miner just to test it out with the stock settings without any changes. So with the stock settings, we can see here that we are getting around 25 mega hash on Phoenix Miner. And if you guys need a tutorial on Phoenix Miner, I've recently just posted one, so I recommend you to check it out. And as for the wattage, we're drawing around 135 to 136 watts off of the wall. So that means 106 watts are for the GPU only, and then 30 watts are for the system, which puts the GPU in a decent place. It's more efficient than an RX 580 without any tuning. So now after we tune up the GPU, we will be able to get a lot better efficiency. So let's go ahead and find the perfect overclocks for it, and then after that, we can run the miner again and then compare the results. So for the overclocks, like I mentioned guys, you will be able to find these overclocks on miningchamber.com. So for the values that I ended up settling on, it was 60 for power limit, negative 200 for core clock, and then plus 1100 for memory clock. And as for your fan speed, you guys can put whatever fan speed you want. For me, I kept it pretty quiet because this GPU does not get that hot at all. So with these settings, I'm getting around 30.8 mega hash, which is really good. So it's almost 31 mega hash. And we're only drawing off of the wall 85 watts for the GPU. So the entire system is pulling around 115 watts to 116 watts. And we can take off 30 of those watts, and then we will be left off with the 85 watts for the GPU itself. And as for your overclocks in HiveOS, it is a little bit different, because in HiveOS it doesn't take an offset, rather it takes a fixed number. So you need to put the double of the memory clock that you put in Windows 10. So in Windows 10 we did 1100, and then in HiveOS we would be putting 2200 for your memory clock. And I'm sure it will be like that for other Linux-based operating systems as well. So please double check and then try to use the values there. And both of these values will also be mentioned on miningchamber.com. So you'll see the first value, which is the offset with the plus sign, and then the secondary value is the fixed number where you can use it for Linux-based operating systems. Now let me give you my conclusion on this GPU. The 1660 Ti is honestly a really great card. When it first came out, it was probably one of the best options you can go with for mining. It's very diverse. It can mine multiple different algorithms really well, rather than just Ethash, which is for Ethereum. And it doesn't run hot, and it's a very quiet GPU, but if you do put the fan speed above 70% to 80%, it can get loud. Although one thing that caught my eyes is the oil that comes out of this card. Maybe it's just EVGA specific, but it did leak some oil. So this doesn't harm your GPU in any way. This is just some oil that leaks out of the card when it gets a little bit hot, and it's not that common, so not all of the models have it, but you don't need to worry about it either. Now what I like the most about this GPU is how efficient it is. You can run like 8 of them with just a 1200 watt power supply. They're really efficient cards, and the best thing about them is that they're super stable. I rarely have to check their settings. I can run them for 2 months, 3 months in a row without worrying about them at all. So in a nutshell, if you do find these GPUs for decent prices like we talked in the first part of the video, then I honestly recommend trying to get them. But when you compare them to a 3060 Ti, then of course it's better to go with a 3060 Ti if you find that one more available, or most of the 3000 series cards in general. But for older generation cards, the 1660 Ti and the Super are definitely one of the good options out there. Now that wraps up the video, guys. If you have any questions or concerns, please leave them in the comments below. The upcoming videos will be the BIOS modding for the RX 580, as well as a comparison between the RX 580 and the 1660 Ti. So these videos will be coming out very soon. I hope you guys will enjoy them. Now that being said, guys, please feel free to hit the thumbs up if you enjoyed the video, and subscribe if you're new here. I have a lot of new content coming out very soon for all the newcomers that you guys will benefit from. And please join our Discord server. If you have any questions, you can always reach out in the server, and then the community and I will try to help you. So thank you guys again for watching this video, and I hope you have a wonderful day.